Welcome back to the Chase Family Arena. Halftime of the opening game of the Connecticut Six Classic with Hartford leading Quinnipiac 32-29. It is our pleasure to be joined right now by Senior Associate Athletic Director Billy Mecca from Quinnipiac, perhaps the most positive guy in the state of Connecticut. It's good to see you in person, having seen you on TV all over the years.
And I watch you all the time, too, man. Thanks for having me.
Your energy is always great. How do you spin this one with all the fouls, though, in the first half?
Well, I tell you what, I'm trying to think of a game where we don't have officials and wondering how would we play if the kids called it themselves. But a lot of whistles, a lot of off-the-ball whistles, and really not a real good flow early on to the basketball game.
We'll see what develops in half two. What are the expectations like in Hamden this year for Tom Moore and his program? We're hearing those four letters, NCAA, because he's been building it in that direction.
Well, you know, Tommy's done an incredible job since he's joined us. Now in his sixth year, he's put us in a position, I think, where we're very confident and comfortable that come late February, Quinnipiac's going to be in a position to either be number one, number two, or number three in our conference. So he's paved the way to what has really turned into a viable option for some talented kids. So, you know, we're going to have a chance.
You have witnessed the growth there in Hamden on campus. It's really been remarkable from a D2 program for Quinnipiac and now, of course, the Division I in the Northeast Conference, and seemingly improving and getting bigger and more compelling as a place to go see a game every year.
Well, you know, I think all that credit, and I've been in Quinnipiac now 35 years, and I think all that credit goes to John Leahy, the president of the university, and he's got an incredible staff. But he first built up the academics at Quinnipiac. We now with a law school and a medical school. You only have 100 schools in the country that have both. So academically, Quinnipiac was always a Division I institution. And now over the course of the last 10 years, you've built an athletic program. I know you've seen the TD Bank Sports Center, which is maybe the best athletic facility, certainly on the East Coast, if not nationally. So we've positioned ourselves at Quinnipiac to be successful, both in the classroom and on the court.
Just about 20 seconds left, Bill. Your thoughts, though, on an exciting announcement last week that the women's Frozen Four will be coming to Quinnipiac in the future.
Jack McDonald, my boss and the AD at Quinnipiac, continues to impress and was able to pull off getting Quinnipiac to host the NCAA Frozen Four for women in 2014 at the TD Bank Sports Center. So it'll be a great event and another way for Quinnipiac to get their name out nationally.
And if people haven't been down to that facility, check it out.
Yeah, come on down, see the game.
Something else.
It's a good place to be.
Thanks for your time, and good luck to the Bobcats in the second half.
Good seeing you. Peace.
32-29, Hartford leading Quinnipiac. Back with more. We'll speak with Hartford AD Pat Meiser after this. You're watching the Connecticut Six on SNY.